Hello, my name's Ian Toombs from gofishing.co.uk, and in this short film I'm going to show you how easy it is to make your own pole rig. Now, many people will prefer buying pole rigs, and that's fine, but when you make your own, it gives you the versatility to be able to create the rig that's ideally suited to exactly where you want to go fishing. Plus, having the knowledge to create your own pole rig will enable you to recycle old floats from rigs that have already been tangled or destroyed or overused. And this is what you need to do it. You'll need a rig winder, a jar of water, could be a spaghetti jar or in this case a cut down pop bottle, permanent pen, pole anchor, your pole float, silicon tubing, your chosen strength of main line, some shot, or if you want to create a bulk rig, an Olivet, and finally a decent pair of scissors. While keeping the line attached to the spool, pass it through the eye of the float. Now thread on the three strips of silicon in this order, two thin ones first, followed by the thick one. And now take the base of the float and thread it through all three strips of silicon, like so. And work the silicon strips along the float stem so that they are equally spaced. And then, while you're using the rig, the reason why the last strip of silicon is so long is it ought to overhang the base of the float stem. This prevents tangles. In the case of this float, it takes 1 gram of shot to cock it correctly. Now, if I was to use an Olivet, I would choose one of about 0.75 or 0.8 or thereabouts, because that gives me room for manoeuvre and you can add extra shot onto the rig to provide the perfect presentation underneath the Olivet. Now, in the case of this rig, I've threaded one Olivet onto the line, trapped with 2 number 8 shots. Some Olivets are self-locking upon the line, which is fine, but in this case this is an inline Olivet, just threaded onto the line. And then underneath that I have placed 3 number 8 shot. Now I'm going to drop that into the water to see how it's set. There we go. By lowering the float into the water you can tell whether or not the rig needs extra weight. Now that, at the moment, is just about right. If the float tip was higher, and you could see part of the body, obviously I'd add more weight, and if the float sunk completely, I would take a shot off, or maybe two. Now what we need to do now is move these shot up the line, like so. Pull that up the line, because these shot were really squeezed onto the line, so it could potentially have damaged it. So I'm going to gently pull them along the line, all 5 of the shot, and discard the line that was originally used to hold the shot. There we go. So this length of line here, you can actually feel the indentations along the line where it's potentially damaged. So I'm going to remove that bit of line now. At the base of the line I've tied a small loop, and that loop will be used to attach the hook length to the finished rig. So the rig is almost complete now. We've got the shot in place, we've got the loop in place, we've got the float in place, lock secure on the line, and now we just need to determine the length of the rig that this is going to be. So what I like to do is use more line than is necessary. So basically, if the venue I'm fishing is say 10 foot deep, then I'll use probably 15 foot of line just in case. So if you hold the float and just pull off enough line. Again, I've tied another overhand loop in the end, and this will be used to connect the rig to the tip of the pole. And now all that's left to do is to clip the rig onto a winder like so, and just simply wrap the rig onto the winder. And now once the rig is in place on the winder, simply pass a pole anchor through the uppermost loop and then pull it securely and lock it around the base prong of the winder. Finally, write the line diameter and the line length onto the winder, and it's ready for storage. There you go. One finished pole rig.